What is good, y'all? It's your boy Abdul. And what I'm about to do is I'm about to show y'all a really good workout for those that's trying to get in and get out of the gym and work on that chest, right? You can knock this out in about an hour, maybe even less than that. So let's get into it. So one of the things you'll find with the chest press is that when you're doing it consistently, your body and your muscles are gonna adjust to the weight very fast. So you'll find yourself increasing the weight probably more often than you do any other machine.
Right now I'm up to 190, all right, 190 pounds. And when I first started hitting the chest press and hitting my muscles and targeting certain muscle groups around 4 months ago, I was at about 110, 130. You know what I'm saying? In that range. So you can see that I've pushed myself to the point to where I'm up to 190 now. You know what I'm saying? On this machine. What you wanna do is you wanna push yourself to the point where if you are doing 10 to 15 reps, you want yourself to be really tired at the end of that set. You know what I'm saying? Because you want to actually put a lot of tension on your muscles. So that's what I try to do. You probably will increase the weight probably once or twice a month. And that's just going to motivate you to want to keep working, right? Because now you see progress. In the trap, I'm like, fuck this, but I'm right back when I finish it. I'm a fly nigga, fuck a sack up. If I like that, make it right back. If my niggas keep my mouth closed, I'm going to make bail. I'm going to fight that. Free tea, slate, free love, Bruce. Know what I'm saying? On a fly machine, I normally do about 3 sets. I normally just do 3 sets on this machine right here, because by the end of the 3rd set, I'm usually like winded. Like I don't know if it's because it's harder. It's a harder range of motion. I don't know if it's because it works a lot more of the shoulders. But I'm usually done by the 3rd set. You know what I'm saying? That's just usually how it goes. Now I'm not even gonna lie to you. For the most part, you don't want to only do 3 sets on your workouts. And that's because you're not really pushing yourself, believe it or not, most of the times when you're doing 3 sets. You know what I'm saying? The people that get a lot of results are the people that are really pushing themselves further than everybody else. So they're doing like 4, 5, 6 sets. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? My camera died right there when I was doing the incline chest press. But yeah, right here though, I'm doing the incline chest press and I'm adding weight. You know what I'm saying? I'm adding weight after that 3rd set, because on an incline chest press, you're actually adding definition to your upper chest. So I want to push myself beyond that, right, and add more weight. You know, I did 4 sets of these. You know what I'm saying? What I do is I do 4 sets per workout, because I started off when I was a super beginner, I was doing 3 sets. But you know what I'm saying? Now I'm up to 4. But like I said, yeah, if you wanna really see some results, do 5 sets. You know what I'm saying? 5, 6 sets. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be burning real bad, but it's supposed to burn, right? You're supposed to be hurting. If I'm not hurting and burning, man, then I'm gonna keep on working out, because I feel like I'm not getting no results. I feel like I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Right? Right here, these dumbbell chest presses. It's more high incline for the upper chest. And I'm not even gonna lie to you, when you use dumbbells and free weights and stuff, that is a good way to make your chest poke out more, right? I'm definitely gonna start doing more dumbbell presses, because I look in the mirror at this and it's like goddamn. But yeah, man, like, you want to do about 15 of these. 15, you know what I'm saying, 12 to 15. It's a good knockout. It's a good, like you can never go wrong with doing these in your chest workout, because you're doing this on top of the machines that you're doing. So This is really targeting the chest area too. Not only that, but you're doing a lot of shoulder and tricep work as well. You know what I'm saying? Very good for the arms. Shed so many tears, make me feel weak, but now I ain't soft my neck. 100 days, 100 nights, 100 days, 100 nights, 100 nights. I gotta get my money right. 100 days. Now, right now I am doing arms every day. Right? So right here, these hammer curls. I'ma tell y'all this. Hammer curls are probably better than actually scratch that. Hammer curls are better than the regular bicep curls if you're talking about just building muscle mass and size to your arms and your bicep area. Right? The regular bicep curls will burn more and they will tone your biceps more. But if you're talking about just making your arms grow in thickness, these are better. Right? So notice how my back is straight. I am swinging a little bit, but as long as you keep your back straight and your chest up, and you know what I mean, and curl your arms, you are doing it the right way. Right? I really had to push myself on this set right here. Y'all about to see me struggling. But yeah, man, I'm training arms every day because I want my arms to get bigger, and I don't care what nobody say about, Abdul, why you training the muscle every day? What about letting your muscle rest? Well, I mean, that's what sleep is for. That's what these supplements are for. That's what we have these things for, right? You know what I mean? So that's what getting, that's why you got to get your rest in on a daily basis. So I want my arms to grow. I don't care what nobody say. Now this is, believe it or not, this does train your arms, but this is mainly for your upper chest as well. If you notice, like, I focus a lot on my upper chest because that is the area that is hardest to get definition, right? A lot of us will notice that when we train in our chest, we start to see the definition in the lower chest, right? But I like to balance it out with seeing the same amount of definition in the upper chest. These right here, I usually do these to finish off my chest workout because you don't even got to put that much weight on it, right? You can go real light and still feel the burn. You want to do 20 sets, then 15, I mean 20 reps, and then 15, then 12, then 10, and then 8, right? As long as you're doing it like that, you are going to see some results, man. You got to push yourself. Like, chest day is probably my favorite day. You know what I'm saying? Chest day is by far my favorite day because it's strengthening my upper body, right? If you got a strong upper body, you feel like the shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get my shit big, though. Like, I'm just getting started. I'm trying to get my shit big. Whoa, dude, what are you doing? You doing pull-ups on chest day as well? Yes, I'm doing pull-ups on chest day as well. Like I said, I'm doing pull-ups every day, right? I'm doing pull-ups every day, man. I'm not playing with y'all. But yeah, man, like, comment, subscribe, and let me know how y'all feel about this chest workout and show me y'all results. I mean, tell me about y'all results, because we getting better every day, like I always see. Follow me on Instagram. Go to sleep, wake up with nothing to eat. Yeah, that's the crazy thing. Sometimes I think I wish I could just blink right out this crazy dream. But reality, it really ain't as easy as I make it seem. Lost my nigga while they off my nigga. I give it all up what it cost my nigga. And I ain't never really gave a fuck about shit, but now I ain't never.